This is a lithium-ion battery on fire. It happened on the North Shore in late June. You can see sparks flying from it. According to the Honolulu Fire Department, the pack powered an e-foil surfboard. They say it was removed from the e-foil board before they arrived. HFD extinguished the fire, then bagged and removed the battery. The cause of the fire determined unintentional. It's a reminder of how dangerous these types of fires can be.
And practically everything that we have, everything that we use now, has got a lithium battery. And that even includes that thermometer that was really popular during COVID.
He says they're desirable because they are energy efficient and pack a lot of power into a small size. But that's also what makes them potentially volatile. Manufacturers have made safety improvements, but there are several things people can do to prevent an accident.
One thing to remember is to fully unplug devices. You don't want to leave them charging overnight.
Don't charge it on your couch or on your bed.
Charge it on a hard surface, away from other lithium-ion batteries. Dropping the battery could create a fire hazard.
Sometimes when they're compromised, so a lot of times if they're like dropped and damaged, or if people aren't disposing of them properly and maybe it gets crushed in, say, a rubbish truck, it can cause a chemical reaction.
Getting the battery wet is also dangerous.
If you get it wet, then it could be, again, a potential hazard. As we said, that water reacts with lithium, so you create hydrogen, which would create a bigger fire hazard.
Kennard says if a lithium battery catches fire, people should clear the area and call 911.
If it's something like an electric car, because those are lithium-ion batteries, just on a larger scale, and also just for our safety, there's really not a whole lot we can do with those electric car, electric vehicle fires. They typically burn for hours.
She says sometimes all they can do is let it burn off. Jen Boniza Cage, 12 News, working for Hawaii.